excited about the event today? You're looking forward to it?
I'm always excited about these things because, to be very honest with you, what happens is that you bring a couple of friends and you say to them that there's going to be some free things, and they look at you in the eye and say, well then, what time? And then you turn up, you get some free beers, and it's a chance for people, I think, to kind of like just relax a little bit. You know, it's very fortunate that you can be at one of these places and just wander around it and pick up some free creams. But no, it's exciting because, as I say, a lot of the time it's about getting together with some friends of mine and family sometimes that I wouldn't usually do.
I mean, as you say, a lot of beauty products on offer today. Do you have any particular products you swear by? Are you into your creams and your face washes and all that kind of stuff?
I do love my face washes, to be honest with you, and I do love my creams. I do. I love my organic creams, and I've got like skin, like, you know, I've not got skin complaint necessarily, but, you know, I do have sensitive skin. So, to be honest with you, some of the things that I have on my shelf today are as a result of doing these gifting suites, because a lot of the time these people come with some very different products. So as it turns out, I mean, I know I say I come here just for a laugh, but to be honest with you, you know, you can walk away with some things that are very helpful.
When you're not applying creams or picking up some free ones, what are you working on at the moment? What's coming up next for you job-wise?
There's something coming out this spring called The Lost Honor, which is about a young man by the name of Christopher Jefferies, who, it's a true story, he was supposed to have killed his tenant a couple of years ago over Christmas, who was found in the snow. They found out that it wasn't him, but not before they plastered his face all over Sky TV and told everybody that it probably was him. And then they discovered that it wasn't. So that comes out anyway this year. The young man who wrote Frost Nixon and The Queen wrote this. So, you know, there's a couple of good people in it. It's going to be a great thing. It's going to be on ITV. And there's a couple of things coming out, but I won't spoil it.
Just talking about that project, I mean, obviously people will kind of remember that because it's not, you know, it's quite recent history. Why do you think it's so important to tell that story and to kind of remind people of what happened there?
I feel sorry for him because he's actually having his life put under the microscope twice. But fortunately, this time, they're clearing his name. I don't know if anyone understands what it must be like to live in an area for many, 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 many years and then be able to go down to your bakery and have them be very nice and give you their sourdough bread every day. And then all of a sudden to be known as a pedophile, maybe a possible murderer, possible this, that and the other, and to then walk around your streets and have your neighbours look at you in a different way. I don't know if you wouldn't want to wish that on anybody. That's what happened to this guy. But fortunately what's happened is people have discovered that he didn't do it. They've discovered that it was completely wrong. What else has happened is the Press Complaints Committee have been slapped on the wrist for various reasons. One of these being, a big reason. And as a result of that, things are changing.